I don't take life for granted. I am a volunteer for disaster relief. I did chainsaw safety, I did flood recovery, and I did rebuild. I find that's helping people, which I like doing. In August 2016, I had a small spot on my shoulder that I wanted to get looked at, and it turned out to be melanoma cancer. And I took treatment for 1 year. I was told that I was in remission. I went back on regular visits to the oncologist, and I had a knot showed up on my collarbone here. It looked kind of like a cyst. And they diagnosed it as metastatic melanoma. So I was just kind of stunned. And I'm thinking, that's a death sentence. So I had to do something. I try to go at things full speed if I can. Pedal to the metal. What's precious to me is able to do the things that I enjoy doing. I like anything mechanical. I like older cars, and the cars that I have are unique. There's always something to do on them. I spend more time with my cars than I do in the house, but I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful for what I've got. I'm alive and well.
Jeff, how have you been doing?
Jeff presented with multiple tumors in his abdomen. He had been told that there was very little that could be offered with FDA-approved options. His doctor had known about a new therapy and sent him to us. I tell all of my patients, whether they have melanoma or lung cancer, if I don't have an 80% shot at curing you, I want you on a clinical trial. There was no question that Jeff would be a great candidate for a clinical trial. I believe that immunotherapies are a revolution in oncology. Melanoma just so happens to have the highest rate of mutations of all cancers. So if you're going to try to solve cancer with the immune system, you want to start with a cancer that looks the most different from all the other cancers. And so that's why I focused on melanoma. Tumor-infiltrating lymphocytes, or TIL therapy, is a form of immunotherapy that uses the patient's own immune cells to fight their cancer. T cells, a type of white blood cell, naturally recognize and attack cancer. These cells are taken from the patient's tumor, multiplied outside the body, and are then put back into the patient's body to target the tumor more aggressively. With conventional TIL therapy, it's not possible to regulate the number of TILs. Also, for some TIL patients, therapy can be difficult to manage. Hari, I really want to introduce you to Kavitha here.
So the major challenges for TIL cell therapy is that patients are different, tumors are different, and TIL cell therapy at its core is a patient-specific, tumor-specific treatment. What works for one patient may not work for the next patient. Our team at Obsidian Therapeutics is working towards a potential solution for this problem. TIL can be enhanced to produce their own proteins called cytokines, which function to fight cancer. The cell's cytokine levels can be adjusted with an FDA-approved pill. Like a thermostat, the pill regulates cytokine production based on dosage. This allows doctors to boost TIL function when needed and dial it down if side effects occur. Having the ability to regulate TIL cell therapy allows a more precise application of and allows the physician to control the therapy for that particular patient in a very specific manner. These T cells have the ability to stay in the patient potentially forever. By having the ability to re-energize these T cells, we hope that the patient has the potential to be stable for a long period of time.
Before you got the TIL on the right side, and right off the bat, we're looking really good.
This type of TIL therapy is still under development, and we're only at phase 2 clinical trials. But for Jeff, his therapy is complete. And while no response to cell therapy is guaranteed or guaranteed to last, since starting in April of 2024, he's required no other treatment.
I do not know what the future holds, but it's refreshing to be able to feel like I feel. I describe myself as a willing guinea pig. I'm willing to do it for the benefit of other people. Just myself.
There is an ancient proverb that goes something like, a great society exists when old men plant trees under which they themselves will never be sitting. Similarly, we hope our technology is paving the way for future generations to develop this further